That's why. City inspectors have condemned the Baltimore row house where the two men were trapped yesterday during that collapse that happened on Monday. ABC 2 News' Jeff Hager joins us now with more on how those workers may have failed to maybe heed the warnings that the structure was not quite stable. Jeff?
Well, Kelly, experts say there's always some risk involved in renovating century-old buildings. But in this case, another contractor says he warned the workers that those walls were ready to come down. It was a heroic effort, and after 4 hours and placing their own lives at risk, rescue workers emerged with the last of two men trapped when the row house collapsed near Camden Yards. Tom Terrazakis has been working on a nearby roof, and he says that victim was the same man who he warned of structural flaws he spotted in the building just 3 days earlier.
I let him know several things was wrong with the building, and you could see the top floor, the part of the roof shifting forward and leaning back, and they said they were going to take care of it.
The city has condemned the building, and firefighters returned to the site to see how much of the rubble must be removed to safely retrieve their equipment used during the rescue. Assistant Housing Commissioner Eric Booker says, in addition to the proper plans and permits, this incident should serve as a stark reminder for others trying to rehab homes throughout the city.
Anytime during your building process, if you see something that seems like it's failing, you know, don't try to be the expert. Call in a structural engineer, have them take a look at it before you continue to build, because the last thing that we want as we continue to bring the city back is for people to lose life in the process of construction.
The owner of the row house, Lloyd Williams, says the building had been inspected several times, and he received no forewarning of a possible collapse.
Back when I purchased the property, there were bows in the front wall, there still is, and there was a bow in the interior party wall, but that's nothing I haven't seen before.
For his part, Tom Terrazakis says the workers did attempt to brace the wall after his warning, but it wasn't nearly enough, and he's just glad it didn't prove to be a fatal mistake.
And I'm looking at the rumble, and I just can't believe that nobody did out of six people. So somebody was looking out for them. We thank that.
The owner of the home says one of the workers has been treated and released from an area hospital, while the second one suffered bruises and a collapsed lung, but he's expected to make a full recovery. Jeff Hager, ABC 2 News.